Good morning, good morning. This is welcome to my shop, Slop's Plastic Cups. The last video of the slop in the shop, this is another, or you're going to be seeing the slop in the shop. So I'm just doing a new intro for the rest of them from now on for a while, but I decided to change it. So this is Slop the shop. This is the things I'm doing. I've got two or three projects most of the time going on. Instead of trying to make videos for each project dedicated, I've decided just to take the videos of what I'm working on, and it might be a compilation. It may be one project. So that's going to be what the Slop the shop is. So enjoy. Well, today I ordered some extra cutoff blades from Banggood because I have damaged on one side. So we're going to see how they do. It's fairly inexpensive, so I bought two of them. I'm still waiting on my inserts that I've ordered. And I stopped at Harbor Freight today. I'm bad to call it Harbor Freight. And I got two rolls of welding wire because I run out. This is early March, and you've seen my laundry before. This, what you're seeing here hanging on my clothesline outside, is a set of what they call card file cabinets. This particular one right here that's drying from primering is come off of a, excuse me, I'm handheld. Came off of, I bought it at a flea market several years ago, and I had it on the bottom of my little cart that I used to have for my drill sharpener before I took it off, because when I moved here to Dallas, my space become a lot more limited. So what I've done is I've taken pieces of hardboard and glued inside of this. This is like Gorilla Glue. This is just let creep stuff sliding out the back. This one here had set outside a little longer, so I primered it. So that's what the situation, that's what this one's drying from primer. By the way, if you listened a minute ago, that was my neighbor's air compressor. I thought I'd forgotten to not turn mine off. So this is my Grizzly. And these cabinets here were white, and I had some green paint and already painted them. And they're dried, or drying fairly much enough. And what the two befores you see laying on the floor is to take up the space that the cabinets will sit. I'm going to reorganize this, and more or less, I'm going to put tooling in them cabinets. The ones you see outside will get a little green paint to go along with it. And well, that's what'll set there. And then I've got more storage, which is something I need more of. And I've had these, this particular one right here, like you said, I've had it laying here for a good while. And I see a little light spot. I might hit it with a little paint here in just a second. Next, I will admit that I've got several different shades of green. And I probably covered this before. This G750G, the center of it was actually had a little metal, what you call a beauty piece, that would fit between the stands. And when I assembled my lathe the first time, I was doing it by myself and had an accident. The lathe got kind of sideways. The biggest damage was the stand, the beauty piece, more or less. So I've ran this lathe the whole time without the beauty piece. And what I did, and I think I showed this in the video, is I've took some bed frame, which I use for angle, and made this shelf that sets in my lathe, and I've got some things setting on. So what I'm doing is now going to use this other unused open space to put these two cabinets in. So that's the kind of work, what the one outside you see is for. You'll notice my power tool bench has finally got the Delta on it. Now, I didn't know anything about the Delta. This grinder here, this belt sander, came from the same gentleman that sold me the mill. And actually, he said this came from the same place as the mill, and they give it to him, he says. So I have no reason to doubt the man's word. Well, he gave it to me, and I just, it been in my other building. So the other day I got it out, plugged it up, and it wouldn't start. What was wrong was the switch was bad. Well, I just have a house switch. So you hear it running. The problem is it takes a 42-inch sanding belt, a 1-inch by 42. They're not available local, and I'm waiting for an order. The other thing, it had a little Delta knob, and one of the hand wheels was missing. So this morning, I just knocked a couple out pieces of some aluminum here and knurled them so for the belt changes there. So I just fixed them this morning too. And what I done is I thought very seriously where I wanted to get rid of this or not. And I just now see I'm going to have to, or lay it down. As see, this will move. So what I'm going to do is keep this around for whatever reason I think I might need it for. Might just leave it in that position. Which is something I may just do, just leave it in the flat position and use it like that. Sometimes with this old thing, it's just nothing. That's the reason I wanted to replace it. It ain't the greatest thing in the world. I mean, it's a harder freight unit than you know, what you expect. Adjust it. Now, I may just leave it there and use the flat sander, which is probably what I'll do. And you see, I still may have some issues here, and I may have to move it around. I may have to get rid of it anyway. But time being, it's just sitting there, and I fasten it down with a couple screws. And if it doesn't work out, I can always move it. I won't use the primarily. I want to use this Delta when I get it finished. Right now, I got it there just because I need a belt sander till I get the belts. In case something comes along, I'm gonna use it. Most of the time, all I use my belt sanders for is a lot of this stud where I cut these screws off and redo them. So that's what I've been working on a little bit the couple days. I've worked on my fence outside, done some projects. This morning I went and helped the brother-in-law. So that's kind of where we at today on all our projects and whatnot. So I thought I would just kind of throw these in, and this will probably go into one of my slop shop videos. And the grinder's still sitting here. I've got to get some more work done on it. You'll notice it's just sitting there behind the bandsaw, and I haven't gotten more on it. I want to work on it. I've got a lot of projects just in my head I will work on. So this is the kind of things I just go from one thing to the other. There's no real rush. So I'm going to finish the belt sander, which is the next. I'm going to get this running tomorrow. Hopefully my belts come in tomorrow about lunchtime from in the mail from Amazon. And I'll have it running. And then after I do that, I'm going to... I got a meeting in the morning, so that's going to be tying me up. So, by the way. Oh, and another little thing, and I'll show you right quick. This is my camera rig. And what I run into with my camera rig is, you'll notice I'm holding this in one hand, hold my older camera, is I got screws in it. Well, what happened was, you've seen it a couple times in some of my videos, the camera rig falling. Well, what happened is it fell and landed and busted this front piece off. This is an old, cheap, you know, inexpensive indicator stand that I used to put my GoPros on. And basically, you can see how it's rigged up. So what I ended up doing was putting some screws, drilling and tapping this and using the screws to hold the knob in so I could still use it. I mean, it works. Works pretty decent. And that's what I've been using to do a lot of my camera shots up on the machines with a GoPro. So that's kind of what we had on that. I still need to make my soft jaws for this vise. And a couple other things I really want to do. I think I got an idea. I'll walk outside and I'll show you something. This is my back area here, you know, I keep stuff in. And there's that other vise. I'm really working on an idea, and I have it maybe this summer. I get some warm weather some time. Is I'm thinking about coming in here with this and cleaning it up a little bit. Put some of this stuff in different places. I mean, I need to leave the air compressor out here, but I really want to make this into an area where I can put a, maybe run a little piece of a wall down to here, and maybe a piece of wall somewhere. It's just kind of, and I can maybe put a like a press right back up against the wall in that corner so I could use it. Or either this front corner, one of the two, kind of make it a little more useful and rearrange this. And another idea I'm floating around, and I just really haven't got, again, it's just time and money, is I've seen on another video, of course I'm going to paint the shop sometime this summer, but one of the things I'm floating in my head is building me a porch. It's basically a roof and a porch out here, and maybe this again, leveling it up a little bit and filling it with gravel or something and make it like a work porch. So like from large projects outside, maybe a little welding or something like that, I can just bring it out here, maybe put a windbreak up and use it. And that's something else I'm kind of floating in my mind. This depends on, a lot of it's going to depend on how my finances work when I get completely set up on my retirement. That's one of the things I'm doing tomorrow is meeting my retirement guy. So basically what it is, I got the pension from my employer and took it in a lump sum, and we're going to do some financial arrangements with it. And I have one rental property that I get some income off of. And, well, I'll just tell you, I'll flip the camera around and kind of do a selfie. I'm going to tell you, Mr. Kilroy talked about selling his, and mine, I'm just not in the mood. But there's one caveat. I have a problem. I have somebody managing. I only have the one house. It's fairly new, belonging to my mother. It's been remodeled, and it's still tied up in a bit of a deal with me. But here's the thing. If I sell it, I can't guarantee the same income out of it, putting an investment. So for me, the income off the house is a really good deal, especially paying property manager. And I have a friend of mine who does my property managing for me, the ex-supervisor of mine at Eaton. And he's managing my property. And what he's doing is he's charging me a flat monthly fee, very reasonable. And it's not a third of the rent, it's actually probably a fifth of the rent, what the house is renting for. And he's my interface and there's my tenants. And then the rent is deposited into an account. So if the rent ain't deposited in by the cutoff day, today's the 5th of the month, basically cutoff day, by the end of the day, if it don't show up in the bank account, I just text my friend, he gets hold of them. So right now, it's what, you know, I checked a few minutes ago. So basically, that's how that's managing. So that, between that and my retirement, I may do better than I think. So obviously there's not no money coming from YouTube. And I ain't interested in working for a living permanently for anybody. I mean, I've done that for 40 years, worked 7 days a week. I'm tired of working. So I can make it without working. And, I went and helped my brother-in-law this morning, and I got families coming in this summer. The stepdaughter and her husband's in the military. He's taking 30 days leave this summer and coming and spending the summer here. He's spending 30 and she's spending 2 months. So basically, the time the kids are out, our grandkids from Washington is going to be here all summer. And that may slow the videos up some. So we don't know yet. I'll see how it all plans out. So this is today's update, kind of what's going on. We'll probably do some more. It's a fitness slot in the shop. Have a great day. Like I say, I remind you one more time. You like what you see? Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. Tell your friends. Have a great day.